Hello dear students, welcome to online CET class for NEET and Karnataka CET. And in this video also I am continuing discussion on the multiple choice questions on human reproduction from past year question papers. So let us move to the questions. Extrusion of second polar body from egg nucleus occurs after entry of sperm but before fertilization, after fertilization, then before entry of sperm into ovum simultaneously with first cleavage. What is this? During oogenesis, from one oogonium only one ovum or egg is produced. Another haploid set of the chromosome is entering into the small structure, haploid structure called polar body. So the question is with reference to second polar body. Second polar body edrinda produce aagthada? Primary oocyte produces first polar body, and two second polar bodies are produced from, one is from first polar body and another is from second polar body. Sorry, another is from secondary oocyte. So, our secondary polar body yavaga remove aagthada anuvanta prashne. So, answer for this one is after entry of sperm before fertilization. Yavaga sperm egg na penetrate maadi enter aagthada egg olagadege. Once the sperm enters into the egg, but innu egg nucleus and sperm nucleus fuse agirudilla, fuse agokinta munchane, the second polar body is extruded, and this is known as the PBE, polar body extrusion. And once the polar body is removed, the cytoplasm, egg cytoplasm or the sperm enter aagthada, then there will be fusion of the nucleus of both sperm and egg is observed. Then, select the correct sequence for transport of sperm cells in the male reproductive system. Vala easy. Select the correct sequence for transport of sperm cells. What is the site of production of sperms in the testis? Seminiferous tubule. Seminiferous tubule ge connected ducts yavu? Reed testis. Reed testis in the vasa efferentia. Vasa efferentia to epididymis. Epididymis in the vas deferens. Then to the ejaculatory duct, where the sperms are collected in the male body until they are released from the male reproductive system. Then urethra. Last option or last part is urethral meatus. So, where is this particular option? Seminiferous tubule, then connected ducts are reed testis, vas efferentia, epididymis, highly coiled duct of male reproductive system, where the first maturation of the sperms is observed and temporary storage site of the sperms, then vas deferens. Through the vas deferens, the sperms are transported to the ejaculatory duct. Then finally, they are released through the male reproductive system through urethra and urethral meatus. So, B is the right option for given question. Then moving to the next one, it is match the following. So, let us take the pen and mark them. In the column 1 and column 2, the options related to menstrual cycle are given, because look at the phases: proliferative phase, secretory phase, menstruation. So menstrual cycle is the reproductive cycle of primate mammals, and in human females it is repeated for every 28 days or on an average 1 month, during which the shedding of the endometrium is characterized, the bleeding occurs, and unfertilized egg is also removed from the female body. So, what are the phases of menstrual cycle? menstrual phase, proliferative phase, ovulatory phase, and last is secretory phase or luteal phase. So what are these phases? The proliferative phase is nothing but follicular phase, during which the primary follicle gets transformed into secondary follicle, secondary follicle gets transformed into tertiary follicle, and it gets matured as Graafian follicle. That is why the term is proliferative. One by one, step by step, changes are observed in the structure of primary follicle in the ovary, hence it is called the proliferative phase. Secretory phase, it is nothing but luteal phase. Why the luteal phase is called secretory phase? Because after ovulation, the ruptured Graafian follicle forms corpus luteum, and that corpus luteum continuously produces the progesterone. The secretion of the progesterone will be more, so that secretory phase is also called luteal phase. Menstruation, bleeding from the female reproductive system due to breakdown of endometrial lining. For every particular cycle, for every repetition of the cycle, the new endometrium develops within the uterus. How many wall layers are there for the uterus? Perimetrium, myometrium, and endometrium. So perimetrium, outer protective covering. Myometrium is very important because myometrium undergoes vigorous contraction at the time of parturation or delivery of the baby, and endometrium is the fertile region of the uterus or fertile layer of the uterus because it is involved in the implantation as well as it participates in the formation of the placenta. So placenta formation adre mother body in the endometrium tissue galanna contribute maadutada, and fetus contribute maadutada. At the same time, the developing blastocyst gets attached to the wall of the uterus, which is called implantation. Adu yav wall ige attach aagtada antantandre, it is endometrium. So that the right option, let us select which one is. For A, it is 2, for B, it is 3, and for C, it is 1. So the right option for this question is option D. Hormones secreted by placenta to maintain the pregnancy are the very important question, and theoretically, neevu idanna study maadiri, ellavu theoretically bandidde, but idu direct question. Placenta is the temporary tissue which develops only during the pregnancy, and this placenta is produced from association between maternal tissue and fetal tissue. Maternal tissue yavudu contribute maadutada? The maternal tissue contributing for the formation of the placenta is the endometrium, and extra embryonic membranes of the fetus are also contributing for the formation of placenta. So placenta is a temporary structure. Yadarle produce agirthada? Formed by association between the maternal tissue, and maternal tissue participating in the formation of placenta is nothing but endometrium. At the same time, it is produced. Idu vandu. The second tissue present is extra embryonic membrane. Extra embryonic membranes are given by fetus. They are amnion, chorion, yolk sac, and allantois. But idrolaga chorion is the main extra embryonic membrane which forms the placenta along with endometrium. So different hormones secreted by the placenta during the pregnancy are HCG, human chorionic gonadotropin, HPL, human placental lactogen, and progesterogens and estrogens. So the right option for this one is option D. HCG expansion is human chorionic gonadotropin. See, chorion is participating in the placenta formation and chorion is belonging to extra embryonic membrane. So that chorion secretes the human chorionic gonadotropin. Gonadotropin it is. Then HPL, human placental lactogen. Human placental lactogen is another hormone, and two more names are directly mentioned, progestogens and estrogens. So these are the hormones secreted from the placenta and they are essential to maintain the pregnancy. Then moving to the next question. Amnion of mammalian embryo is derived from, interesting question. Amnion of mammalian embryo. What is that embryon? Amnion is nothing but extra embryonic membrane. Amnion yadrinda derive aagtada andre yadrinda produce aagtada anta prashne. Ectoderm and mesoderm, endoderm and mesoderm, ectoderm and endoderm, mesoderm and trophoblast. Remember, amnion is the thin membrane that surrounds amniotic cavity, and within the amniotic cavity, amniotic fluid is present, and amniotic fluid surrounds the body of growing fetus. Remember, this amnion of mammalian embryo is derived from ectoderm and mesoderm. Then moving to the next one. The difference between spermiogenesis and spermiation is that, again, direct question, what is the difference between spermiogenesis and spermiation? Spermiogenesis and reno, spermiogenesis is nothing but conversion of non-structural, non-functional spermatids into structural and functional sperms. It is called spermiogenesis. Let me mention the definition. It is spermiogenesis. So what happens during the spermiogenesis? Non-structural and non-functional spermatids are converted into structural and functional sperms. The process is called spermiogenesis. Another name of the sperms is, they are also called spermatozoa. Sperm andru vande, spermatozoa andru vande, idu spermiogenesis definition. Illinnondenada spermiation. What is that spermiation? Spermiation is nothing but release of sperms from testis. Release of sperms from testis is called spermiation. So testis olaga sperms produce aadmele, they are getting the nutrition from Sertoli cells. That is why Sertoli cells are also called nurse cells. ಸರಟೋಲಿ ಸೆಲ್ಸಿಗೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ, ನರ್ಸ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ನರ್ಸ್ ಸೆಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಷನ್ ಸಿಗುತ್ತದೆ. ಹೆಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ಡ್ ಆರ್ ಎಂಬೆಡೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸರಟೋಲಿ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಸೋ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದ ನರಿಶ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಎರಡೂ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ನೋಡಿದ ಮೇಲೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದು ಕರೆಕ್ಟು ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ, ಲುಕ್ ಆ್ಯಟ್ ದ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಸಿ, ಥರ್ಡ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ನನ್ನು ನೋಡ್ರಿ. ಇನ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮಿಯೋಜನೇಸಿಸ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮೆಟೋಝೋವಾ ಆರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಡ್, ವೈಲ್ ಇನ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮಿಯೇಷನ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮೆಟೋಝೋವಾ ಆರ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಸರಟೋಲಿ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫೈನಲಿ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟೆಸ್ಟಿಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮಿಯೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಸಿ. ದೆನ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟೇಷನ್ ಆಕರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎಪಿಡಿಡಿಮಿಸ್, ವಾಸ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್, ಫೀಮೇಲ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೀಟ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟಿಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್. ಬಟ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಮಾರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನೆಸಸರಿ ಟು ನೋ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟೇಷನ್. ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟೇಷನ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಗೊತ್ತಿರಬೇಕು. ಅಂದರೆ ಇದನ್ನು ಡಿಫೈನ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬರ್ತದೆ ಅಥವಾ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ನನ್ನು ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು. ಸೊ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಸೆಕ್ಚುವಲ್ ಇಂಟರ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ದ ಸೆಮೆನ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಫೀಮೇಲ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್. ಸೆಮೆನ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಚಾರ್ಜ್ಡ್ ಆರ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಫೀಮೇಲ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ಐ ಆಮ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ನಂಬರ್ 7. ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್, ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಸೆಮೆನ್? ಸೆಮೆನ್ ಈಸ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಮಿನಲ್ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಮಾ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ಸ್. ವೆನ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಎಂಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಫೀಮೇಲ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್, ದೇ ಅಂಡರ್ ಗೋ ಎ ಪ್ರಾಸೆಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ಫೀಮೇಲ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ಸು ಯಾವ ಪ್ರಾಸೆಸ್ಸನ್ನು ಕ್ಯಾರಿ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಬಂದಂಗಾಯಿತು? ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಸಿ, ಫೀಮೇಲ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ನೌ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟೇಷನ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಫಿಜಿಯಾಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್. ಎಲ್ಲಾಗಬೇಕು? ದ ಫಿಜಿಯಾಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಆಕರಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್. ದ ಫಿಜಿಯಾಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆಕರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಸೋ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಆಕರಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ಅಟೇನ್ ability to carry out fertilization. ಸ್ಪರ್ಮು ಫೀಮೇಲ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಎಂಟರ್ ಆದ ತಕ್ಷಣವೇ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಕೆಪ್ಯಾಸಿಟಿ ಇರುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಕೆಪ್ಯಾಸಿಟಿ ಬರಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಕೆಲವೊಂದಿಷ್ಟು ಫಿಜಿಯಾಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು. And all those physiological changes occurring in the sperm accounting for the fertilization ability of the sperm is called capacitation. And the capacitation is carried out with the help of uterus enzymes. Enzymes of uterus, they help in capacitation. And one more important point here I would like to mention, non-mammalian sperms, wherever the sperm is produced as male gamete, non-mammalian sperms, they do not undergo capacitation. They don't have ability to undergo the process of capacitation. After releasing, they have the ability to undergo the fertilization. So the right option for this one is option C. Then moving to the next one, fertilization in humans is practically feasible only if humans olaga fertilization aagbekadre yavaga aagthada possibility enada anta question. So let us have the look at the option. Let us have a look on options. Sperms are transported into vagina just after the release of ovum in fallopian tube. Impossible, because vagina is not the part of fertilization. The ovum and sperms are transported simultaneously to ampullary ischemic junction of the fallopian tube. The ovum and sperms are transported simultaneously to ampullary ischemic junction of the cervix. The sperms are transported to cervix within 48 hours of release of the ovum in uterus. So humans olage fertilization execute aagbekadra egg release aagi 24 hours complete aagabardu, sperm release aagi 48 hours complete aagabardu. Within that period, if both the gametes come in contact with each other in the ampullary ischemic junction, then there is a chance of fertilization, because ampulla is a wider part of the fallopian tube, which is also called oviduct. Ampullary ischemic junction, infundibulum, ampulla, isthmus, these are the parts of fallopian tube, and fallopian tube is also known as oviduct. The infundibulum ends with finger-like projections called fimbriae, which receives the egg when it is released or ovulated from the Graafian follicle from the ovary. So correct option for this one is option B. Egg and sperm simultaneous agi ampullary ischemic junction nige transport aagbeku, and ampullary ischemic junction is a part of fallopian tube. So the right answer for the question is option B. Then moving to next one, select the incorrect statement. Yavudu incorrect ada ella hormone gala bagge irodu incorrect statement anna identify maadbeku. FSH stimulates the Sertoli cells which help in spermiogenesis. FSH stimulate the Sertoli cells. Male body valagu FSH and LH sperm production, spermatogenesis anna control maadthava. Female body valagu oogenesis anna stimulate athva control maadthava. LH triggers the ovulation in ovary. Very correct statement. LH surge. When the level of the LH increases in the female body during mid of the cycle, 14th day of the menstrual cycle, the egg is released from the Graafian follicle and the process is called ovulation. LH and FSH decreases gradually during follicular phase. Is it possible? LH triggers the secretion of androgen from the Leydig cells. So only one incorrect statement given in the option is LH and FSH decrease during the follicular phase. Ulta idu FSH and LH increases during the follicular phase, because follicular phase iddaga primary follicle iddaddu secondary, tertiary and mature follicle agi convert aagbeku. So follicular maturation ige FSH is essential, and once the follicular maturation occur to release the egg from Graafian follicle, there is requirement of LH. So erdo hormone gala concentration no female body valaga increased irthada, decrease alla. So the wrong statement given is option C. Then moving to next one, which of the following cells during gametogenesis is normally deployed? Direct question no and easy question. Yav cell gametogenesis valaga deployed irthada anta prashne. So all the cells are participating in the spermatogenesis. Let us write their ploidy. spermatids are a product of meiosis too, therefore it is haploid. Second polar body, it is produced during oogenesis, it is also haploid. First primary polar body is also haploid. Spermatogonia, starting cell for the spermatogenesis, this is the only cell which is in the diploid condition. So the right answer is option B. Which of the following events is not associated with ovulation in human female? Ovulation antandre enu? Ovulation is nothing but release of egg. Yav stage olag irthada? Egg is in the secondary oocyte stage. Release of egg from graafian follicle is called ovulation. Yav sentence ovulation ige sambandhilla. Fully development of graafian follicle. Graafian follicle fully develop aadre matra egg release aagtada. Release of secondary oocyte. Hormone necessary for the ovulation is LH. So the one statement which is not related to ovulation is decrease in estradiol. What is this estradiol? It is a type of female hormone estrogen. So estrogen is one type. Either the amount decrease, this is not associated with ovulation in human females. Then moving to the next question. In human females, meiosis 2 is not complete until secondary oocyte. First meiosis na matra complete madirutada. Innu adu second meiosis na complete madirudilla. So what is the question? Second meiosis yavaga complete aagtada? Second meiosis is completed at the time of fertilization. First question nalle study madidvi. So fertilization in sperm enter aagtada egg balada avaga second meiosis complete aagtada. So right option is option A. Then which of the following is not an important component of initiation of parturation in humans? What is parturation? Giving birth to fully developed fetus at the end of gestation period or at the end of pregnancy is called parturation. So parturation agake oxytocin beku, then increase in estrogen and progesterone beku, synthesis of prostaglandins beku. But ille sambandh padlarda statement antandre it is release of prolactin. Prolactin is necessary for the production of milk from the mammary glands. So, prostaglandins andre en? They are also the hormones which help in contraction of uterine muscles. Not only at the time of parturation, even the menstrual cycle iddagu, prostaglandins secrete aagtava. Under the influence of these hormones only, the shedding of the endometrium is observed or occur and cramps. The pain during menstrual cycle or cramps is produced due to the action of prostaglandins. So the right option for this one is option C. Then 14th, the shared terminal duct of reproductive and urinary system in the human male is. Edu nanne first part video olagu discussion ige bantu. Common opening or common structure for both sperm and urine is urethra in case of human male, because urinary system and genital system are associated. Hence in males it is called urogenital system. The main function of mammalian corpus luteum is to produce. The direct answer, progesterone. The progesterone is the hormone which is secreted from the corpus luteum. And remember, the corpus luteum is the structure produced from the ruptured graafian follicle after ovulation. Then next question, menstrual flow occurs due to lack of progesterone. ಯಾವಾಗ ಪ್ರೊಜೆಸ್ಟಿರಾನ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ಲು ಫೀಮೇಲ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಒಳಗೆ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ, ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಯೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆನ್ಶುರಲ್ ಫ್ಲೋ. ಮೆನ್ಶುರಲ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಪ್ರೊಜೆಸ್ಟಿರಾನ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು. ಯಾವಾಗತ್ತದ ಪ್ರೊಜೆಸ್ಟಿರಾನ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸು? ವೆನ್ ಕಾರ್ಪಸ್ ಲ್ಯೂಟಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಕಾರ್ಪಸ್ ಅಲ್ಬಿಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಕಾರ್ಪಸ್ ಅಲ್ಬಿಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್, ಇಟ್ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ರಿಪಿಟೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆನ್ಶುರಲ್ ಸೈಕಲ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಸಿಕ್ವೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್? ನಾಲ್ಕು ಆಪ್ಷನ್ನು ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮೆಟೋಜೆನೇಸಿಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆನೇ ಅವ. ಇದರೊಳಗೆ ಯಾವ ಸಿಕ್ವೆನ್ಸು ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನನ್ನು ಕರೆಕ್ಟಾಗಿ ಹೇಳ್ತದೆ? ಸ್ಪರ್ಮೆಟೋಗೋನಿಯಾ, ಸ್ಪರ್ಮೆಟೋಸೈಟ್, ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ಯಾಟಿಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮೆಟೋಝೋವಾ. ಸೊ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಸಿ. ಸ್ಪರ್ಮೆಟೋಗೋನಿಯಾ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಡ್, ಸ್ಪರ್ಮೆಟೋಸೈಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಡ್, ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ಯಾಟಿಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಹ್ಯಾಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಡ್. ದೆನ್ ಫೈನಲಿ ದೇ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಮೇಲ್ ಗ್ಯಾಮೆಟ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮೆಟೋಝೋವಾ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ಸ್. ದೆನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ವಿಚ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫಾಲೋವಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಲಸೆಂಟಾ? ಇಟ್ ಸಿಕ್ರೀಟ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ಟ್ರೋಜನ್, ಇಟ್ ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟೇಟ್ಸ್ ದ ರಿಮೂವಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವೇಸ್ಟ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋ, ಸಿಕ್ರೀಟ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಟೋಸಿನ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಪಾರ್ಚುರೇಷನ್, ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟೇಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಸಪ್ಲೈ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಯಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋ. ಸೊ ಯಾವುದಿದ್ರೊಳಗೆ ರಾಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟು? ಬೇರೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. ಪ್ಲಸೆಂಟಾ ಸಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಯಂಟ್ ಟು ದ ಫೀಟಸ್, ಪ್ಲಸೆಂಟಾ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಫೀಟಸ್, ಪ್ಲಸೆಂಟಾ ಸಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಟು ದ ಫೀಟಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಸಿಕ್ರೀಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಈಸ್ಟ್ರೋಜನ್ ಬಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಟೋಸಿನ್. ಆಕ್ಸಿಟೋಸಿನ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಿಕ್ರೀಟೆಡ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಮದರ್ಸ್ ಪಿಟ್ಯೂಟರಿ ಟು ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟೇಟ್ ದ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಯೋಮೆಟ್ರಿಯಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಯೂಟರಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಪಾರ್ಚುರೇಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಬರ್ತ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬೇಬಿ. ಸೊ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಸಿ. ದ ಲೇಡಿಗ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಆರ್ ಸಿಕ್ರೀಟರಿ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್? ಅಗೇನ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ಲೇಡಿಗ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇರ್ತಾವ? ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಲೇಡಿಗ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಟೆಸ್ಟಿಸ್. ದೇ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಇಂಟರ್ಸ್ಟೀಷಿಯಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್. ದೇರ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಟು ಸಿಕ್ರೀಟ್ ಮೇಲ್ ಸೆಕ್ಸ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಂಡ್ರೋಜನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೇಜರ್ ಮೇಲ್ ಸೆಕ್ಸ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟೋಸ್ಟೀರೋನ್. ದೆನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಂಡ್ರೋಜನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡರಿ ಸೆಕ್ಚುವಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮೇಲ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ದೇ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ದ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮೆಟೋಜೆನೇಸಿಸ್. ದೆನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ವಿಚ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫಾಲೋವಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವಯಾಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ಸ್, ಮೆಮಾಲಿಯನ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ಸ್? ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಈಸ್ ವಯೇಬಲ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಅಪ್ ಟು 24 hours. ಸರ್ವೈವಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ pH ಆಫ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಇನ್ ಅಲ್ಕಲೈನ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಮ್. ವಯಾಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಟರ್ಮೈನ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಮೊಟಿಲಿಟಿ. ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಥಿಕ್ ಸಸ್ಪೆನ್ಷನ್. ಸೊ ವಿಚ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್? ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಈಸ್ ವಯೇಬಲ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಫಾರ್ ಅಪ್ ಟು 24 hours. ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ರಾಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಫೀಮೇಲ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಒಳಗೆ 5 days ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ಸು ಬದುಕ್ತಾವೆ, ಬಟ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಕೆಪ್ಯಾಸಿಟಿ ಎಷ್ಟಿರ್ತದೆ? ಓನ್ಲಿ ಫಾರ್ 48 hours. ಸೊ ದ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಎ. ದೆನ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, the secretory phase in human menstrual cycle is also called, aglene bantu discussion ige secretory phase andre en agirtada, corpus luteum formation agirtada. Then why it is called secretory phase? Because corpus luteum continuously secretes the progesterone. So the right answer is luteal phase, and it lasts for about 13 days in the menstrual cycle. Signals for parturation originate from, it is a definition of fetal ejection reflex. signals for parturition originate from both placenta as well as fully developed fetus. There will be release of oxytocin and that ensures or supports the parturation, nothing but release of fully developed fetus from the female uterus or womb of the mother. Identify the human developmental stage shown below as well as the related right place of its occurrence in the normal pregnant woman and select the right option for two together. Developmental stage correct irbeku, adu yalli yav part olaga grow aglikattada adu correct irbeku. So adanna mark madri anta kottirodu. Late morula, middle part of the fallopian tube, blastula, end part of the fallopian tube, blastocyst, uterine wall, 8-celled morula, starting point of fallopian tube. So which one is the right answer? See, fertilization yell akta the fallopian tube olaga, ampullary isthmic junction olaga. So allinda zygote iddu cleavage process olaga enter akta. It undergoes repeated mitotic divisions and finally gets transformed into blastocyst having 32 cells. So adu move akta akta konege wall of the uterus bandu attach aagtada. Aa attachment process igene we call it as implantation and both the options correct irodu idu ondr olagene blastocyst and uterine wall, nothing but implantation. If for some reason vas efferentia in the human reproductive system gets blocked, the gametes will not be transported from, okay, testis in the reet testis ge, reet testis in the vasa efferentia ka, vasa efferentia block agiddilla andre munde epididymis vasa difference ge hogtada. But illi yavudu block aagtada ant helara question olaga vasa efferentia gets blocked. Testis olaga sperms produce agava, reet testis bandava, but vasa efferentia block agiddak munde ell hogalla, they are not transported to the epididymis. So the right answer for this question is option A. So these are some questions that I wanted to discuss from the previous question papers of CET and NEET. Hope the discussed part is clear for you, and thank you.